Camtasia 2021 is here. In this fast-paced video, you're going to get a brief look at the new features in Camtasia 2021 for both the PC and the Mac. Media mats provide visual effects that make it easier to apply mats to a clip, like making a circular talking head or playing a video behind text. Emphasize audio lets you choose an audio track to be the main audio. This lowers all other audio tracks, so your voice comes out on top. Proxy videos make Camtasia previews faster. High-quality videos might play slowly in the preview, but with proxy videos, they're smooth. Grouped annotations now have a quick properties tab where you can easily set colors and text. The editor button in the upper right of the quick properties tab lets you name your annotations, labels, and link them so one change can apply to multiple items. Disable effects allows you to keep effect settings, but temporarily disable the effect so you can see what things look like without it. If you have several effects in your properties panel and you want to collapse some, you can double-click the effect title to collapse it. Motion blur is a new visual effect that makes your annotations appear blurry while they're moving. Camtasia 2021 includes over 75 new transitions to change from one visual to another. You can right-click a transition on the timeline to disable it temporarily if you need to work with the item without the transition being applied. Corner rounding is a new visual effect that allows you to select a corner and make it rounder like a button. Lottie files are animated image files that can be scaled up without losing resolution. An audio meter is now above the timeline to the right to show decibel levels. You can click the meter to see a larger vertical version. Auto-normalize lets you set the maximum audio loudness. Previously, you could only set this for the entire project, but now you can set it per clip when it's enabled for the project. You can now expand the width of your tracks to show more text for your track labels. When you click a color drop-down box, there's now a My Colors section at the bottom that lets you add several custom colors for reuse. When you open Camtasia 2021, you'll see a new welcome window that includes projects, training, and help. When opening previous versions of Camtasia, you would see the Getting Started project. There's no longer a Getting Started project, nor is it available from the Help menu. Hovering your mouse over thumbnails in the media bin now allows you to preview the videos by scrubbing through the media. When you place your mouse cursor over the canvas and scroll up, Camtasia now zooms to that part of the screen where your mouse cursor is, instead of just zooming to the center. TechSmith Audiate is an audio editor that looks like a word processor. Camtasia is now integrated with the Audiate editor. Let's now look at a few Windows-only options. The new recorder is larger with updated buttons. While the tools menu isn't available at release, expect it to return in a future update. When you save your projects, Camtasia defaults to a standalone project. This new type of project is a folder that includes your project's media. When you click the plus sign to expand a group, it now opens into a group tab. You can close the group or click the main timeline tab to return. There are several Mac-only updates as well. LUTs, or lookup tables, are visual effects that enhance the color of a video. Expect color LUTs to arrive to the Windows version in the future. Automatic animation is the canvas mode where you can move your playhead, adjust the screen, and Camtasia will automatically create animations for you. Instead of using Command-C and Command-V to copy and paste media, you can now use Command-D to duplicate media. If you want to go to a specific time in your project, you can click the time code under the canvas or press Shift-T and type a number, like 1200, to go to 12 seconds into your video. If you go to Edit, Zoom, and Pan, you open a pop-up tool. The tool adds an animation where your playhead is and allows you to set the zoom percentage and screen position. In the Camtasia Preferences window, there is now a Camtasia System Permissions button that displays the Camtasia permissions like microphone and webcam permissions. Also in the Camtasia Preferences window, there's an option to split animations under the Timeline tab. You can now zoom your canvas to percentages like 800, 1200, 1600, and 2000%. There are now 6 new Pan and Scale shortcuts under the Edit menu that let you pan and scale a clip to fit on the canvas or to set percentages like 25, 50, 100, and 200%. If you made audio edits to a track, you can right-click the clip or press Option R on your keyboard to restore the audio to where it was originally. There's now an Add Exported Frame button above the timeline. Pressing this button creates an image file of your canvas, adds the file to your media bin, and adds it to your timeline. More detail on all these features can be found in the links below, as well as inside my Camtasia courses at cammastery.com. Thanks for watching.